What you know about college debt and financing on today's Think Share. Hello and welcome to the Daily Think Share. My name is Zach. I'm here to bring to you what I've been thinking about, sharing about, talking about, listening to the Doesn't Belong in Math class. If you're new to the channel, I invite you to subscribe. I'd love to have you and deliver your messages every day. So one of the things that is pretty important about college, so this is part three of my dealing with stressful college stuff series. If you are a student that's planning on going to college, here's one thing that I'm really glad that I did. So I was debating going to Northeastern, UMass Amherst, UMass Dartmouth, UMass Lowell, URI, UNH, I think. I got into Northeastern. It was gonna cost about $45,000 per year after a $5,000 scholarship they gave me. And UMass Dartmouth was gonna cost around, I believe it was $15,000 or $20,000 per year when I applied. No, I went to the college tour, loved Northeastern. I loved UMass Amherst, which I got waitlisted to. After I went to the UMass Dartmouth one back in the spring of my senior year, I said to my parents, like, I really don't wanna go here. What I ended up doing was going to the accepted students day at UMass Dartmouth, and they told me that I could transfer into UMass Amherst after that. Now, I could have gone to Northeastern, and I think that I would be in a lot more college debt today than I am, and I probably would have ended up with a similar or the same job, maybe a different engineering job, but probably not paying that much more. So what I would invite you to look at, if you're going into your senior year, you're gonna be accepted to a couple places, I would say, think about your financial situation. One thing that's very relevant today is that there's more student loan debt in America than there is credit card debt. And it's really easy to get into credit card debt. Therefore, it must be that much easier to get into college loan debt. It's really easy to get into college loans. However, it's not easy to get out of them. You can actually declare bankruptcy on your credit card loans and it'll take a huge hit on your credit report, but you don't owe the money. Student loans, there's no bankruptcy from that. It stays with you the rest of your life. I might be wrong, and I would love for someone to do the research on this real quick and comment. I think that if you die, other people have to pay it. It might be forgiven upon death, but I'm not sure. So that could be false information, but what I understand is college loans are gonna stay with you. Credit card debt, you can do other things about. So what I would say is, first off, you wanna have expectations with whoever might be helping you out paying for college. So if it's parents, if it is scholarship money, if you were to lose a scholarship, who would help you pay for it? And I would think first about that. How much is it gonna cost you out of pocket? How much is it gonna cost your family out of pocket? And are those dollars worth it? So for example, Northeastern would have cost me $45,000 a year times 4 years, actually 5 years at Northeastern, but we'll just say four for now so we can compare apples to apples. 45 times two is 90 times two is $180,000. UMass Dartmouth and then UMass Amherst, which I ended up going to as well, was about 20, 25, so $180,000 versus $100,000. Now, an engineer, they're gonna get out of college maybe by the time people are applying now, maybe they'll be averaging around $70,000 per year after that. So, after I graduated college, I got to a job and I was in there with people that went to Ivy Leagues. I met people from Northeastern, Harvard, UMass Lowell, UMass Amherst. We all ended up at the same place making the same amount, which is interesting. What I'd want you to consider is the name brand that you're paying for when you go to that college, is it worth the experience? Is it worth the money that you're going to be paying down the line? I know some people that chose to go out of state, maybe to UConn, URI, UNH, UVM, UMaine, all those different places that are similar to your UMass Amherst, although smaller, or UMass Dartmouth, UMass Lowell. However, they paid the out-of-state tuition, which is at least, I believe, $10,000 more per year, at least for all of those schools. Some of my friends from New York, New Jersey, Rhode Island, Connecticut that went to UMass Amherst with me were paying an extra 10 grand per year. I think here's what my main point is. Student debt is very real. It's not gonna feel real going into it and getting a loan. Unless you're paying for yourself and you're feeling the heat of that loan immediately, I would caution you in taking out big student loans. Either way, you want to be careful with your financing and you want to consider, is there a cheaper option? If I have that cheaper option, would it work for me to, you know, get all my general education courses, like my math courses and my you know, some people are still taking algebra 2 in college. Go to a community college for that. You don't need to pay $2,000 per credit for that. It is okay to pay plenty for college as long as you get that what you're paying for is the experience, not the education. Because I would say that for the most part, most colleges are not gonna give you that much more value for the dollar value that they give them. It's a name brand, right? It's branding, they do a great job of it, and it's the place. If you can tolerate the place, I would say I had a great semester at UMass Dartmouth. I'm glad that I went there, so I got to taste UMass Amherst and UMass Dartmouth. You know, it's not certainly not the prettiest. I made great friends, and it kind of depends on how willing you are to make good friends and whether you're willing to commute. If you're gonna commute anyway, go to a cheaper school, I'm telling you. If you have a scholarship, do the scholarship. Don't let any of this conversation affect you. Thank you for watching. I hope this was useful. For those of you that are debating on your colleges, leave them in the comments. Say I'm this or this, and maybe I'll ask some other questions if you like this conversation. Thank you for watching. Stay weird.